Now, sports with Chris Duer from the University of Illinois Sports Desk.
He is the longest tenured play-by-play announcer in Oklahoma State athletic history. But Cahokia native Dave Hunziker's tenure in the booth opened under the darkest of clouds in Stillwater. In the immediate wake of his predecessor Bill Teagan's death, one of 10 casualties of a tragic 2001 plane crash that devastated the Cowboy athletic community.
I mean, trepidation as to whether to take the job. Joe Castiglione was a huge help to me. Longtime AD at Missouri and now at the University of Oklahoma, and if not the best athletic director in the country, certainly one of them. And he helped me a lot in getting involved in the position. And we got to about early May after the accident had happened and things were evolving. And I called Joe. I said, "Oh, Joe, I don't know. I don't know if I should do this. This may be more than I can handle." And Joe being Joe said, "Look, I wouldn't have stuck my neck out if I didn't think you could do it. I know absolutely for sure you can do it." And he said, "I'll tell you what, here's what you can do. If you don't want it, you can sit around and wait 10 years for the next Big 12 job to open up and hope the stars line up the way they have on this one." He's like, "You need to do it. You're going to get the job. Let's go." It's like, "Okay, Joe, let's do it. All right, if you have that much confidence in me, then you know what? Then maybe I should not have any fears." And that really helped me because when I came, people were just so good to us. That's the key. I'm not sure I could have survived at many schools under those circumstances, but the Oklahoma State people are unique. They're very thoughtful. They're very supportive. They're huggers. I mean, Oklahoma, everybody hugs each other, and they don't do it now, but that's what they typically do. And that helped me tremendously.
I have to imagine, though, at some level, because of the strangeness of that specific circumstance, you're basically walking a community and a fan base through a really rough patch of time.
And I haven't told a lot of people this, but I guess it's been 20 years I can share it. And I'm not making this up. I told my wife, Mary Beth, I said, "You know, I think I can help them. If I can do this, I think I can help them." I felt like there was kind of a, I don't know that it was a calling, but it almost felt like if I can, you know, and maybe it'll be somebody else that does it, but whoever it is can help just by doing nothing extraordinary, but by letting them know that we're going to play games and at some point the games will be fun and they'll get to be more fun and we'll win a lot and we'll lose a few. And then some years we'll win a few and lose a lot. But all those things that were enjoyable, not just the games, but getting together with people, getting together with friends, you know, being a student and going to Gallagher-Iba Arena or Boone Pickett Stadium and experiencing that, those things will be fun again. And we'll continue on with those things, but never losing sight of the 10 people that were lost in that accident. And so, yeah, I felt that pretty much from the day that I decided I might get involved in the job. I remember telling my wife, Mary Beth, like, I think we can help. I feel like there's a way we can help. If it's done the right way, it maybe can help a little bit.
I'm a firm believer that people who truly love their job don't really feel the passing of time. It's like you're so excited to get to the next day that all of a sudden you look and Dave, you're 20 years in. I mean, at this point, is it still the same for you? Is it still the same level of excitement?
Every game is its own story. They're never the same. And you never know what's going to happen. And so it's never boring because it changes. And then it takes on these wild storylines that nobody saw coming. And that's when it's really, really fun, is the unexpected. The good thing about working on a college campus is you eternally think you're 30. And that's where I am. I don't even remember how old I am. Half time, I don't even, it's like, I'm 50. Am I really 53? Seriously? How? I think I'm 53. How could I be 53? I'm not 53. I'm 30. I'm on a college campus. You're around these young people that are chasing their dreams and have a wonderful enthusiasm about just about anything in sight. And it just, it's fuel. It's like the fountain of youth.
It had to be fun a couple years ago when the Clark County girls went to a Final Four and Clark County football went in a state championship. You get a sense of pride from that far away still as an Indian grad?
I have my Clark County 2008 state championship shirt that I still wear to get my soda. Absolutely, of course. And, you know, there's family members. you know, the Bevins family is their cousins because Melissa, of course, is a second cousin. So there's a lot of times you know them or you don't know them, but you know mom and dad or, of course, grandpa and grandma are close family members. So, oh, absolutely. There's still a lot. I mean, that'll never change. I mean, that will never change. It's not only even the sports things, but I root for that area economically to have success in some of those areas that have struggled to hopefully turn around and, you know, wish that someday, hope someday, maybe I can play some role in helping that. I don't know what it would be, but would love to do it because that place, it instills great values in people.